Hi friends, welcome again with another interesting topic today. I'm Dr. Rupa Shah. I'm an allopathic doctor, but I've been practicing all kinds of natural remedies and therapies and plant-based diet for last 37 years, plant-based diet for about 13 years now. So today the topic is the purpose of disease. The traditional concept that we have about disease is like an enemy, something that is going to attack us as if it is coming from some foreign land, enters our body and we have to fight and we have to kill it and we have to somehow, you know, overcome it. But the real understanding of disease is very different. If in a room 10 people are sitting and there is one person who is infected with a particular infection, the other nine don't automatically become victim of the same illness. Some of them get mild, some of them get severe, and some of them never get it. Why that happens? Because the disease is a partnership with our body and the germs. The germs are not attacking us. They always look for a very suitable environment. What we call it as the soil. If your body is suitable, you will get the disease. Otherwise, you do not get it. And whenever a disease happens, it is body's attempt to actually come back to normal. So, for example, if there is swelling, there is pain, there are some discharges from your body, there is stiffness, all these things, you know, are actually body's attempt to overcome a disease or overcome a toxicity or overcome an imbalance that has happened in our body. So should we see disease as our enemy or our friend? So let me tell you honestly, disease is our friend. I have met quite a few people who have completely changed their life when they were attacked by a disease. Let's not even use the word attack. When they got a particular disease, for example, a rheumatoid arthritis, it's an autoimmune disorder. Then someone who figured out how, you know, the disease came and how do I help myself to transcend it, overcome it. Then the life changed completely. On the way, you learned a lot about healthy lifestyle, many healing techniques. You also learned about your mind and emotions. And then you learn to correct it. So I always say that every disease comes with a lesson to learn. There is no mistake in our body. Our body does not lie. A disease happens for a reason. There is a complete story. Our body is very transparent. So, for example, if you were having a very busy life, you were overworking yourself, you were losing sleep, you were not eating properly, and then 5 days later, you come down with an attack of something, you label it as viral. You say, I got viral, I'm under weather, or I'm down. But initially, you were creating a soil or an environment for a disease to happen. So it does not happen just like that. Every patient who walks into my clinic, I ask a simple question. What was your life like before this disease happened? A few months before, for example, a patient told me that, you know, she got high blood sugar. I asked a simple question, what happened to your life a few months prior to that? Was there any difficulty, any stress, any story? She said, I suddenly lost my father. And then, you know, in 3 months, I was diagnosed with high blood sugar. So then I relate this to the emotional shock, which was not healed properly. Now is lingering into your system and the shock is registered in your solar plexus. Your pancreas is now under functioning and now you get high blood sugar and are called as type 2 diabetes. So this is the link between mind, emotions and disease. It's very important that, you know, we pay attention to this holistic picture. Diseases don't just happen just like that. Because we human beings are not separate from our environment. We are connected with our environment. We are sum total of us and our environment. the nature, the season, the place where you stay, the people you are surrounded by, the food that you eat, the air that you breathe, the water that you drink. You are sum total of that. You are not just a separate human being. You also have your genetic predisposition. So that also plays role, you know, in creating a soil. So whenever disease happens, it does not happen just like that. It doesn't happen and give us a surprise. There is a reason, there's a process, there's something that has happened that is wrong. And so disease comes as a process of cleansing, process of balancing. It is our body's attempt to come back to equilibrium. Yesterday, I was talking about inner doctor, how our inner doctor looks after us. So this is in partnership with our inner doctor. The disease works to heal ourselves. It's our body's attempt really to transcend, to overcome. So all the symptoms of disease are to be, you know, listened carefully. We should not suppress. For example, you have pain, you have stiffness. Do you want to take a painkiller and not listen to the message? No, definitely not. Pay attention. It's happening for a reason. There's a migraine headache. What is causing my migraine headache? And listen to it and then work at the cause of this, and then the disease will go away. So finally, disease is our friend. Look at our friend. It is helping us to learn a lesson, to correct something, and then move ahead of it. If you don't correct, you just take some drugs to suppress the symptoms, you are not going to get better. I have patients of allergies. They will take some, you know, anti-allergic medicines for years and years. There are patients who have acidity. They take acidity medicine for years. That is not the cure. You are suppressing the symptom. You are adding some other chemical in your system. Probably that chemical drug is going to create another disease by itself. So when patients come to me, I have the symptoms of the disease to listen to. And some of the symptoms are also because of some of the drugs that they are taking. So I have to differentiate that this has happened because of some of the drugs that they are taking, and this has happened because of the disease itself. Now, the disease does not go away like that. You have more and more things happening. And there's a possibility that one drug leads to another drug to another drug. So that's very complicated, and you finally don't overcome. So a few years ago, I had a patient who came to me in my clinic for a cough that was not going away for 3 months. And she also had high blood pressure, and for that she was taking a medication. She was taking something for her cough also, but no doctor saw her properly that her cough was side effect of a medication that she was taking for blood pressure. So what's the point of giving all the cough syrups when you don't find out and correlate that, oh, this is a side effect of this medication? When we figured out, we said, all right, let me, you know, figure out that blood pressure is the thing that you have that needs help really in the first place. But beyond that, she also had thyroid problems. So she was also taking a medication for thyroid. So now three different symptoms, three different medications, and patient very confused, depressed, and not going anywhere. This is going to be very confusing. It's always retrace back to the roots, the why the disease has happened. Disease means there is no ease, there is no comfort. There's something that has gone out of balance in our body. So it's always remember that a disease happens. We have to look for the cause, learn a lesson from that cause, and not create the environment again for the disease to come and then transcend. So next time you get cold, you don't take any medication to suppress the cold, but accept, welcome it as a body's way of healing. And you can also do something to heal yourself so that you do not get the cold again. Same for any other symptoms like painkillers, or for example, if you get fever, please don't take something to suppress the fever. Body is very intelligent. Body raises the temperature to do some work. It's just not a mistake, you know. The fever has a reason. Body is trying to raise the temperature and then overcome the disease. So I always, you know, support my patients in sustaining the fever for a day or two and let it break naturally. As far as possible, I give support of natural remedies and diet and lifestyle and rest, and then overcome your fever. So that's the correct way of doing it. And if you suppress your fever, your body was trying to throw some toxins out. Now those toxins will remain in your system, and very soon at some point your body will create another disease or something else will come up. So body constantly looks after, tries to heal. Disease is a process of that healing only. And so I recommend that you pay attention. And this is the purpose of disease. Whenever disease happens, really find the purpose. There are people, as I said, they always have understood that how they are blessed by the illness and then how their life completely changes after that when they learn how they overcame their disease and they think that they had the disease in the first place. So this is the way I would like to propose the approach. Do not see disease as enemy, but as our friend, and pay attention and then move ahead. So thank you very much for listening to me. Tomorrow I'll be back again with another very interesting topic. So see you then. Watch out for my post and the topic for tomorrow. Thank you for listening to me.